popular presidents in American history. The conservative Republican garnered over 60% of the popular vote in 1920. He was a genial, clad, handy fellow whose rock solid jaw and magnificent profile lent an aura of authority. This August 1923 death, likely from heart failure, sparked a nationwide period of mourning. Unfortunately, Harding was temperamentally unsuited for the presidency. He was happier playing poker and drinking during the Prohibition era than overseeing his administration. This laissez-faire attitude towards economics paralleled his hands-off approach to subordinates. It's hard to pick just one scandal from Harding's brief residency. His attorney general told immunities from prosecution. His attorney general sold immunities from prosecution. His head of the Veterans Bureau stole millions of dollars before fleeing the country. Harding himself lost the White House china in a poker game and had an illicit sexual encounter in a coat closet. But the scandal that seemed to have matured is the Teapot Dome. The details began emerging just days before Harding died. His Secretary of the Interior, Albert Fall, had persuaded Harding to transfer control of two federal oil reserves, one at Teapot Dome, Wyoming, and the other at Elk Hills, California, from the Navy to the Department of the Interior. The move made sense on a bureaucratic level, but it also worked to Fall's monetary benefit. Two of Fall's friends, Pan American Petroleum's Edward Doheny and Mammoth Oil Company's Harry Sinclair, paid him over $500,000 to work the deal. After securing the transfer, Fall leased drilling rights to his benefactors as dirt cheap rates with no competitive bids. Doheny was awarded Elk Hills and Sinclair got Teapot Dome. Fall claimed to have done no wrong when news of the bribery broke. Doheny and Sinclair were just helping a friend in need, he said. He saw no reason to protect federal lands from exploitation. In his mind, conservation was a job-killing plaything of FA East Coast elites. His story proved unpersuasive. With his one-year sentence for bribery, Albert Fall became the first cabinet secretary convicted for crimes committed in office, and the first to serve jail time. A judge canceled teapot dome lease in 1927. Sinclair served 6.5 months for contempt of court, baffling a jury, found Doheny not guilty of bribery. So, in this first picture, here, says, Attorney General, MIP, and it lampoons Attorney General Harry Doherty's futile attempt to conceal the scandals of the Harding administration. And then here, as the political scandals of the day, but history books sort of glean over that. You never really, when you're taking like a history class, you generally don't read about the, you know, medium level stuff. I guess this would be considered big stuff. You tend to, but small or medium level stuff you don't, and that happens all the time. Okay, guys, so this was the Teapot Dome scandal, and still in our historical section of the Life magazine's Scandals in American History. Bye.